copy. Coelacanth turbo. So this is a build I've been working on for a while. I first have been under a 2-year-old video from a basic Coelacanth combo 2 weeks back. The first video was total obsessed and went through around 24 different builds. And now I feel like this is probably the build I'm most happy with, kind of. So the basic premise of the build is to get out my Superancient Deepsea King Coelacanth, which once per turn is a soft once per turn. You can switch one card and special summons 9, level 4, lower fish monster to the fossil pump from your deck. But it can't be an attack, so you can not really without that. You can also reflect himself. On the combos, which quick effect while this card is face up on the field and is targeted by a card effect, quick effect and trigger to another fish monster, negate that effect if you destroy that card. So if you get Imperm or Veilered and you go the keeper line, you can tribute to keeper to keep them safe. So that's neat. But otherwise, the deck is really susceptible to hand traps. As basically all the combos require 2 cards, except Summoner Monk. But if you go, you turn for Princess, because you have the normal Summoner, and you get Ashed, you're kind of fucked unless you have Burr and Coelacanth on hand. Or yeah, even if you have their Coelacanth on hand, just use your 1-1 summon and Princess. That's why you want to play 2 and play 1-1-1. Because I'd rather see 1-for-1 than Princess. But she is basically another copy of the Dream, or like the Swedish. Because he is integral to the lines, or his easiest way to get into a combo, which requires Leafish and one other water level 4, which can be a Meruka, which is a newer water support, which would be really good if you didn't miss timing. When a water monster effect is activated, quick effect, you can special summon this card from your hand. I think if it would have been worded differently, so it's when a so that you're required to special summon him when a water monster effect is activated, then you wouldn't miss timing, so you would be chain blocking and thus keeping your Leafish or Beautiful Princess safe, and you would instantly get into a combo. But now it misses timing, so if they Ash or if they basically interrupt any of your abilities, then you can't special summon this responsive machine. Which is really annoying. Because the deck is fragile, since the entire deck revolves around this one card. That's why we play Sherry Unicorn. Because it's nothing more, I think it's more funnier than special summoning unicorn, seeing him eat an Ash or an Imperm, and then already having Burp in hand, or having Princess and Angler or Naruka or Summoner Monk on hand. So he's just a big magnet for any kind of interruption. I've seen him eat both an Ash and an Imperm in the same turn, because he played a fragile deck which didn't want to use the extra deck, which is really funny. But normally they just Ash and you get to see what the opponent is playing, or they Imperm him and you smile and say, okay, I'm gonna keep playing my combo now. So when Coelacanth is at level 7, you can almost summon him up of Burp. So if you open up Burp and Coelacanth, you can just normal summon him. pitch a card and do full combo, which is really funny. But the extra deck is really kinda open. It's kinda open. You can play Double Baron for a real swing end board, or you can play Borreload Savage Dragon in main, or basically any rank 4 or synchro between 7 to 10, I guess. The same with Link Monsters, you can basically play anything, which makes this deck really fun. Because this is like a more standardized kind of combo mass negate deck. But I've seen others play it like a like an OTK deck. So if they decide to print really funny cards just to break the game, then you can probably make it with this deck, since you have so many tools at least but the basic combos require you to play Monosaurus, which is a hard combo to turn. Lugaris, which is your usual combo starter, and or Abyss Keeper. Abyss Keeper not so much, since it puts in an upward slope where you can kind of bait the gate, but it still requires you to have two cards. But if you already have Coelacanth on hand, it's really nice. So if you open like Shabana and the Leafish and the actual Leafish and the bird from hand, you play bird and of course you go to keep the special summon from hand. The only time you don't wanna see Coelacanth in hand is when you have Angler, because you're most likely required to special summon Angler, which is also a special summoning from hand. So, Angler is like a double-edged sword. It's a really nice extender, but also some hands are really frustrating to see, where you're required to special summon Angler to make Lugaris, and then they infern Lugaris, and you're stuck there with Queen Corp. Like Ash, maybe again when you have like, okay, this would have been fine if I hadn't been locked at all, especially some time, so I can run on the speaker and let you see the camp that way. But anyways, so the deck, as I said, revolves around playing free seal cam, because you can see him in hand, you can hit him to raid in multiple ways, it's really nice. There's also a way to play the Kashtira packet. I have played around with a bigger Kashtira engine where you actually go into the Kashtira combos. So you can make rank, you can make single plays and still go into your XC stuff, so you don't automatically lose single cards by barrier, I guess. And they're also really nice to eat up the gates in Unicorn. The first showcase here of the deck had a really awful Mecha Phantom Beast combo as well. We basically made Garus and Monosaurus before going into break aside. Like, we played with no safety. It was kind of funny. But for starters, play Free Summoner Monk. And I used to play Imperm, but I switched to Dark Ruler, because if you lose a die roll, an Imperm might like help if the opponent bricks, whereas Dark Ruler, they just can't respond to it. So even if they build up a massive board, you still play really safe. It might depend, you might want to play Imperm depending on your total matchups or the matchups that you think you're going to face. So you can play it in your side, or play Dark Ruler in the side. But the reason I want to play three of them is to play more spells, because all the other spells are defensive ones. Or have start combo. You can choose not to play Reborn. But once again, I want to play spells with impact. So even if I don't open Summoner Monk, and teach them they will please have some utility. So you can reborn, seal one of their cards, or if they decide to, for some reason, pop one of your openers, like Shabana, or Leafish, or they pop the Keeper, you can say reborn it, try again. But we play one combo degrade and three cross out is really, really important because the deck is so susceptible to getting hand trapped. We're kind of forced to play a lot of safety cards. And Leafish, which I've touched on, is like the second part of the deck. It's like lungs. You need them to breathe and to be able to get into most of your combos. Naruka, Silent Angler and Shabana are extenders. Your generic level 4s, which you need to be able to combo. And then we play Royal Swamp Eve and Oyster Meister to go into or to facilitate most of our level 7 plays. Basically, anytime you want to go into Appaloosa, you make a level 7 with Oyster Meister and Royal Swamp Eve. You also need it to make the or one of the barrier, or in this case, the testudo combos. You can't play barrier statue or the torrent or testudo erat numen. It kind of depends on once again what you think you're gonna be up against. My locals, I think testudo might be the better call, but. Since we have a few water decks running around, I feel like the very statue isn't gonna help. But being able to lock opponents out of getting to their higher end monsters will help, since they will be forced to deal with it before they can combo. So you're gonna go into main 2, and the combo where you're going to Numen usually have. Free Mat, Apo, and Baron. I'm gonna show replays after I've gone through the deck. For other synchro cards, other tuners, we play Lotinus. In the replays I'm gonna show, I play the level 3 Fishborg. But it's up to you what you want from your tuner, which is kinda weird to say. But with Gluttonous you get the extra attack, if you don't get hand trapped, depending on how many cards the opponent has in hand when you synchro this card, the synchro monster gains 200 attacking defense. Whereas the fish board has recursion where you can, I think, banish another water or fish from your graveyard to special summon from the grave. You can only do it turn after the center, or not the same turn for center. I also played the level 1 Fishborg Launcher, which you will need to facilitate some plays. And then hand trap lineup Ash, because it's probably the best hand trap this format. And then we play a Nibiru and Lady Crow for as Imperm targets. I would play Imperm as well instead of one card ruler, or just one play a 45 card deck. It's really hard to play this as a 40 card deck, since the most obvious one would be to not play the Unicorn and the Bird, but then you are even more susceptible to hand trap. You don't really have a way to trick your opponent into thinking that you're playing something else. Then the extra deck is really open. The only cards I recommend, or I feel are must plays, are at least one Baron, Minoceros, Glorious, and this Keeper. Everything else is up to you. The other ones, you can play any generic level 2. I choose to play Area the Water Charmer because it has some extra utility. In other combos that I'm going to show, I play Deep Up and Underworld. But once again, those were influenced by older green face I'd seen. They also play Lingerevo to facilitate a Palooza place. So if you have Palooza, then you can of course to play Lingerevo as well. The builds for the combos are really flexible. I play Anemone because recursion, and sometimes it helps to build up boards, especially like really weird and funky hands can somehow be made playable, or you can extend combos in weird ways to where even if it's wouldn't have expected to be able to make certain monsters and still count. Because you can get back one card with 1500 less attack what monster. So if you for some reason you've expended all your uploads in the gates and the Baron in their turn and they still somehow have the way to negate your shuffle back of some really crucial card, you can go into an enemy and get it back and still be able to play. It's really weird, doesn't really come up that much, but for some versions as well, if you want to do the barrier lock with Prima Donna and Trishula, it's needed, but it's like a really niche hands, and you lock yourself in the waters, so you can of course make Baron and a Palooza before doing it, in which case you don't really need it. Then the side deck is kind of whatever you need. I play Abyss Keeper, Baguska, and Shengyi. I would like to play Baguska in the main, however Breakosack as well can unclog your hand. If you open like no, if they know what you're playing, and you open up Unicorn and Coelacanth, and they wait to hold your hand trap until you get Coelacanth out, then you can go into Breakosack, special D tokens, and have like a pop. Or if you have, because you get 2 tokens at level 3, if you somehow can get to level 1, synchro out, which can be 1-for-1. You can go into Minoceros, special summon, and back to Coelacanth and try again. So, there's like, Dracosack has added safety to play through certain hands. Whereas Baguska, if you open up playable, which would be like Angler, Shabana, Crossout, Ash, I don't know, McDark Ruler, you would be able to make Baguska pass, which would be really nice in some hands, but you aim to play out the full combo or combos rather than just turtle up and defend. Because I find that plays are really boring. Also play Cosmic. Cosmic can be substituted for Twin Twisters, but since we already discarded card, there aren't very many times that I would see Twister being better, other than if you open like Coelacanth and Coelacanth, Leafish and Shabana or something. Or Angler, Leafish and Angler. The Ash the Angler. You could hypothetically, if you're going second, Twin Twister, send Coelacanth from hand that way. But it's like highly situational, and I'd rather have the guaranteed way to remove a crucial threat like field spells and stuff like that. Also play evenly, so I'd probably side out to Ash and like a Summoner Monk or something, or to Angler and Naruka or something, and play the evenly instead. Same with Gamma Seal. We have Ice Barrier to search Gamma Seal, So you could play Twister and Barrier, Pitch Barrier, Barrier Effect, send Gamma Seal, add Gamma Seal back to hand, and carry through that way. But everything is like highly situational, that's why there's 24 plus builds of this deck, because you can do so many different things. But anyways, enough about me drawing on about the deck, and let's actually show some replays. I don't know which ones are the best. Small fish, biggest sport, B1 I guess. So this is the center combo, we're going to Dugarius. So your Tuneful Princess can be substituted for Leafish, as long as you have a way to get into Leafish or and a level 4, then you basically have a full combo. It will open up. This is to make the Dugarius to summon back to kind of the Great Fish from deck. Here you can see we play Fishborg instead of Luffness. The basic combo here is you summon out Eelmeister, Oysemeister, Swamp Eel, a level 3 Synchro, a level 3 Tuner, and a random level 4. Doesn't really matter, I like to send Leafish so you have 2 in grave in case they didn't throw it. And then you may Baron with the level 3 Tuner and Coelacanth. So now we're insulated from further hand traps. And then we may a nerf level 2 with Dugarius and level 14 summon. And then with Swamp Eel and Meister we make the Minotaurus. And then Minotaurus summons back the Coelacanth. And Oysemeister summons a token. You shuffle back with I usually hold it until we've done the first wave and then shuffle back Minosaurus and the Tuners, but it's up to you, it's highly situational as well. And then we make a blue so with the Minosaurus, the token, so now we have Appaloosa and Baron. And from here, we pitch again, get another level 3 tuner, and then these two can be anything you want. These can be the level 4 tuner, or a level 3 tuner and level 4, two generic level 4s. You can make any level 8 synchro you want. Any level 7 synchro you want, or any rank 4 you want. So make another Baron, and here we go into Bahamut. And another build, we can make the Token Cricket Future. So with this you end on 4 monster negates and 2 omni negates, plus 2 cards in hand. Like I said, you can make anything. With this build, you can make the barrier. This current one is basically the same combo, but with more update cards, so we can skip it. Here we have one barrier combo as well with the small cards. There are many ways. I've seen one build where with the first card set from or get from Coelacanth, you make like Shengis and Bahamut to get Toad out, and then you play on. But I always prefer to go Baron, because it's an Omni, so you're safe from Ash, Imperm, Veiler, any sort of negation that you can throw out at you at this stage. You're safe from everything. Except Droplet, but they can play it on your turn. Unless you go second. And then, as you can see, once again, Nyark level 2, Monosaurus, Oyster summon token, and also to summon Coelacanth. Make up a loser. Now we're actually gonna shuffle back the eel and the guy, the Oystermeister, and the level 1 fishbug tuner. And this is so we can make Prima Donna with the oyster and the eel. And we get the token that we need to make a Synchro 9. So now we make Fish a lot to banish one card from your hand and then put it back with Prima Donna to summon a barrier statue or just to erat numen. Like I said, it's up to you which one you want to make. So I'd say you could side one of them. But I'd prefer to play the testudo erat numen in most cases. Because Marine Cess is kind of popular right now. But unless you think that you're going to be playing against, or have a chance to play against like two or more Marine Cess players, I'd probably play the barrier. Unless there are other powerful water decks running around. But that's the one of the very models. There are Cash. So the usual Cash setup requires Unicorn and Coelacanth from hand. But Unicorn in most cases isn't really used very much. Once again, it's an older build. But the premise is still the same. You make Baron, you make Minoceros, summon back the Coelacanth, token, Charmer. What you could do when you summon a level 3 and a level 4, you use the Unicorn to make Appaloosa. But what I think you can do is you can probably make a 4 material Appaloosa. Instead, get into Coelacanth. I might be wrong, I haven't played in like a week or two. And then you make two Baron and a Palooza, and that's what you end on. Like I say, you could probably extend even further, but this is like the normal ish. If you don't want to go like the fastest way to make this board, unless you want to go into Drake the Sack, which opens up, you know, two level 3 tokens, so you can make some weird plays around that. This should be the barrier combo. So it still replaces you to open either Unicorn and Order plus Coelacanth. Once again, so by making Baron and Minoceros, you get the token. Come on back, Coelacanth. Make Drake Attack. Get two of the level 1 fishboards. So this is another thing. There are other ways to do it, but this is like one of the funnier ways to do it. So then you use the Coelacanth, the Oyster Token, and one of the level 1 tuners. You can't play with just the one. We're kind of forced to play with the two tuners because you need both of them to go Trishula and then straight into Prima Donna. What you probably could do, because this is super unsafe, as you can see, you only have one Omni Negate and we're very stunned. There are other ways to play around that, but it requires you to not start with Unicorn on hand or like on field, or getting rid of Unicorn really early, or summoning back Unicorn like midway through the combo to synchro up or into something else. So this is still like heavily under construction. This is just a way to do it, and take it as a definitive way. Play around yourself with it and see what you can do. There's another like safe-ish way to play the normal combo with the small fishes, you're most likely to do the small fish combo. I can show, like shuffle through some test hands, just so you see how consistent or inconsistent the deck feels. But for me, there are so many opportunities and ways to play around with the deck that the possibilities of the boards you can make can outweigh the few times that you actually brick with it. It's frustrating when you get hand trapped. But yeah. So this is the, this may be my final build of the deck. I own all the cards I've shown in all the other decks. So if you want to test out like one of the 24 variants I have, as you can see, not all of them are Kashtira based, some are the more old-fashioned Icejade ones. So if you want to play a like 10 euro or cheaper deck, you could play the Ice Barrier package instead of the Kashtira one. It has the same purpose, or it serves the same purpose as the Kashtira one, minus the fact that most people are gonna actively hand trap or seek to actively hand trap the Kashtira cards. With Icejade, you can send a card from your graveyard, special summon one monster from your hand. So you wanna see Tremora and Silucanth on hand, and that way get Silucanth out. And Ice Barrier as well. You can use it to play more defensively or to search either Silucanth or... Oh, is it a Kaiju in here? Yeah, but search the Kaiju. We also have Cradle to search for more of. With the extra deck, as you can see here, you have to play Sheng Yin in the main and play Dweller as well. In the third variant, we play Borreload. It's basically the same main deck as the last one, but as you can see, extra deck changes. So you play Dweller. You can opt to play more or less hand traps, you can opt to play Barrier or Numen in main slash side. And it was decided to side out one in turn for something else. Here's a 40 card variant with the Tremora. And here we play the Utopia Great Goose package and the Deepsea package. But here you will end on, like the previous ones, Baron, Bow, and Krish plus Donna and the statue. This one is a cash build. Most of the huge cash builds are with three unicorn. Like I said, the one where I play like the biggest cash factory of the play. Was like triple two unicorn, one or three Fenrir, and then like one or two ogre, and like another unicorn. Because you, once you start playing like a big enough number of Kashtira cards, it's no longer there to bait, but to actually get out cards like Arise Heart and the Shangri Era. So with this one, you could get into Unicorn, Silucanth, Minosaurus, and then make those into Rise Heart after you set up a like another way. So you would go into Dugarus, have Rise Heart, and then sink you into Baron, so you'd have like Baron, Gagaris, and the Rice Art on field. It's a bit safer way to play Kashtira, but you could probably play the same. way, like the same kind of deck. Here you can see some older build with Kashtira form, but with the Erat sword in there. Here's a small world variant, so we played with the Summoner Monk. None of the Icejade cards, so you can also do it this way. Small world, you need a bridge, as you can play at the level 4 Fire Spirit as a bridge, which you probably should. So this is like if you open up a bad extender, or you need to see a way into, if you want to open extenders and leafish or different defenses, you could theoretically small world and get one of them. Or you have something to pitch into the monk. So if I, or once a card, Kashtira cards get banned, I would probably play on more with a small world build. Maybe try to play more hand traps. But because the deck is so susceptible to getting hand trapped itself, I'm leaning more into playing more safety cards, maybe play talents. Here we have a small world, not small world build. I think the extra deck is the same. Just add one more card, I think it's like another. Not something, I don't know, I don't really care. That's another Icejade build. Extra deck, borreload. Like I said, the extra deck is your oyster. You can play whatever you want in the extra deck. As long as you play Minoceros, Vigoris, the Beastkeeper, anything else, it's up to you what you want to play. Another Kashtira. This is the first build. So yeah, Dragai, fantastic. White Aura Whale, fantastic. You, once again, think you're gonna play, or play second a lot, I'd play the Dark Rulers in the main and play Whale, because that way you can clear your entire board really easily. You could probably make it like the instead of going into Baron, you summon the level 1 Fishboard Tuner, yeah, for launcher, make Whale, and then go into Minoceros and play around that. You could probably as well then, you could play Dragite, you can skip Dragite and play like a level 9 or a level, probably play like Psychic and Punisher or some other like bizarre cards to make off of White Aura Whale, or then shuffle in with Knee Fish. You could shuffle back the Fish board going to level 9 synchro. It's really open. You can play Solantis, another great card. I didn't really know how to play around with this card, since I only picked it up, played it a few times, and then decided to branch off from this variant of the deck. Also, Mori of Greed. You don't really want to play it with the Kashtira cards, since you shuffle the water monster from your hand into the deck and then draw cards. So the odds of seeing like an actual starter, so if you open up like Mineraka, Unicorn, Ceiling, or like whatever, Mori of Greed is, it's a gamble. You could play it, but I'd rather not, since we don't play that many water monsters. If you played more, then maybe. But until they add another good starter which doesn't lock us into only XU summoning and looking at you, boss or card. You can also play White Mirror to get some recursion. But once again, there are better ish cards to play. Also, Talents is a good choice because that allows you to rip another hand trap from them, see what they're playing that way. Or draw two cards to maybe unbrick you. In my cases, I've had bad luck in quotations and rip like hand traps or like birth and worry use my summon. So, or take control of one card. Which is good if you go in second, it helps break boards. But in most cases, you either want to draw cards or rip a card from your opponent's hand. There's another one with Foolish Burial. Once again, it's another way to get Coelacanth into the graveyard. But I feel like you have an over reliance on Deepish. So if you feel like you see Coelacanth a lot in your hands, but not enough ways to get him out, maybe consider playing Foolish Burial. But my free time thing on the deck, it's been a dead card more often than not. Once again, if you play more spells in your main along with Thunder Monk, you might consider playing it just because it's a good one of another cash build. A bit different extra deck from the rest, but still doing the great gold package. Another cash build. Cash build with UDF and barrier. So you make this deck halfway through because you need a way to banish a card from your opponent. So it's really kind of tight. You could once again skip playing Draco Sack, but I want the ability to play even more hand traps. So I'm gonna skip playing Draco Sack. Fishula in and one less Baron. So every time like doing two Barons because your end board is or feels safer with two Barons. You can play Bahamut Shark. Also Firecracker if you find yourself going to climb up them. It's nice just pitch it from your hand. It's one more brick. But also, it's won me games. So I went 100%, yes, I discard it and never play it. But it's highly situational. Other small world build. More A. You can see I played around with small Baryon package. Can't really, like, it tries you to like not play the UDF factor team. You need to play more Link monsters in order for this to work. You just need to get Foria into the graveyard in order to search for Regulus. So you could play around with it, but it's like adding one extra negate. So some hands it might be the easiest way to get into a safe position from opening like Lily Boreo and like Fauna or Angler or Naruka, normal summoning them. But since she's sending a wind and a plant, you need to watch a monster for a keeper. So still, you need to get Borea plus a bunch of like bricks. Go into keeper, go into the generic level 2, play this Colosseum, get Regulus out on the field, and then play from there, which is a lot of work to get one negate. So it's more effort than it's worth to play the Ethereum package, but you know, it is what it is. I think that's all. It's a really expensive deck with tons of options. You just gotta go out of the comfort zone and play like tons of different hands, try every different possible combination of cards, you know, see what sticks and what fits and what you want to do with the deck. And this has been my rambles of my new favorite fish deck, and I hope this gets someone to try a new funny fish.